My wife's always been a smiler.
See you?
Gets along with a lot of people, loves animals. She's a strong person, she's a quick healer.
I always tell people, you have to smile a lot, because when you don't smile and you lose your smile, then you understand what you've lost.
Now show me all your teeth and give me a big, big smile. Wonderful.
In 2015, I had an acoustic neuroma removed here in Alexandria. The surgery unfortunately left my facial nerve paralyzed, and so I couldn't move anything on the left-hand side of my face. So I can't blink, I can't hear out of my left ear, and I couldn't move the left-hand side of my mouth.
Using the acoustic neuroma website was really great because that's where she learned about Dr. Boheme.
When I saw her, she was about 13 months out from surgery, holding hope that the face will recover. After about a year with nothing happening, she came to see me and said, my face is not recovered. Is there anything that can be done? And I just told him, yes, there's a lot that can be done.
She spelled the way I spelled it.
So the discussion about what we were going to do for her centered around transplanting the muscle to the face.
The surgery involved removal of a section of muscle from the gracilis flap, which is a muscle in the inside of your thigh. And I mentioned to him that I horseback rode, and I said, do you think that will affect that negatively in any way? And he was absolutely confident, said there won't be any effect, he will not have any issues with that.
So at Johns Hopkins, we worked on really trying to create normalcy in people whose faces are paralyzed. Meaning, if it takes a lot of muscles to create a smile, try to replace as many of those muscles as possible. And that's the technique that we've developed, taking the gracilis muscle, carefully teasing them out, replacing most of the muscles that create a smile. So in the end, we have what we call a multiple vector muscle flap. And what's a fuller smile? When you smile, I want to see your eyes squint. I want to see the lips move up symmetrically. I want to be able to count the same number of teeth on both sides. We don't want the Mona Lisa smile.
3 months and a few days after the surgery on my cheek, I had movement, and it was incredible.
And so with you, you can see the eye squints and gets smaller, the corner moves and the upper lip moves. So that's the difference. And I've had calls and emails early in the mornings, people telling me I saw my face twitch, and it's the best news you can ever have or wake up to.
I ran down to his office. We work in the same building. And I ran down to his office. I said, Tom, look, I could just get a little twitch. He goes, I can see it. I said, I can feel it. It was very exciting.
It looks great.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's been really worth it.
My smile is at least 95% like it was before I had the surgery. And that makes me extremely happy.